let's take a look at this idea of location and observation as we move outside and take a look at, and we're going to pick on this one situation here, which is the tree. So we can start to talk about the what of this tree. So just tell me some very basic observations that you see about this tree.
It's bare.
Bare. So no leaves on it.
It's tall.
It's tall.
It looks kind of old.
Okay. We start to see, and there's maybe some evidence of that, like the moss that's on it, things like that. And so once again, it's very easy for us, and when we're working with students, to start to understand the what of that tree. But now let's start to talk about the where. Now we know that we have some locational tools or some locational language. So what are some of the things about this tree that you see about the where side of this tree? Just the where side.
It's on the west, the eastern part of the playground.
Okay, very good. So we started to use some of those cardinal directions and that specific. Maybe not even being that specific about it, just...
It's on the edge of the... it's on the edge
close
of the
playground.
Field.
It's on the edge of the field area, playground, whatever. So we can start to see that there are lots of things we can talk about this tree relatively. It's on the grass, and there might be some trees that are planted, as we can see in planters over there, that are slightly different. It's a certain distance away from the school.
It's a certain distance away from that other tree too.
Absolutely. Once again, all those things, relative location, that's a very good one. The relative position from the other trees. But then we start to have some absolute ones once again. And we can start to identify those. Certainly one of the things would be...
It's at 50 Bernice Crescent.
Yeah, the address of the school. So it's within the address of the school. Now, we start to see that gets a little confusing. It helps us to a certain degree, but there are a whole bunch of trees around here that are going to have that. So we sometimes have to work those out even more. And it was interesting that it was identified upstairs that one of the most common things we use, though not necessarily in language, is the idea of latitude and longitude. And latitude and longitude is a very, very interesting one because it is the only true universal locator. Our students are always saying to us, well, why do we need to learn about latitude and longitude? That's the reason. They start to be very comfortable with that when they understand that we need to use the language of where. Okay. So in actual fact, latitude and longitude is the most unique and the only true unique way that is universal in this world. There is not a country, a language, a group of people that don't use latitude and longitude as their primary measure. Okay? Now, what is interesting was that was always something that we had to get from maps, from paper maps, things like that. And it was hard with students because it was hard to translate. But today we have the power that it is in all these various different devices.